अहोषस्वरुप्तायां कुक्कुटाङ्कुजतोषपान् ग्रीलकन्यकृतिर्माधवयो यांशं कृष्णं भोगयन्ति वन्दिना गाय सुषुनिद्राणि मन्दाय In the presence of Garga, each day is an integral day, and each night, honeymoon night. But morning is always too hard, because as soon as the dawn approaches, why have Sri Krishna sleeping with him, strangling, tangling, and snuggling Sri Krishna with their arms, would be scared of separation and cursed each of those cocks that crowed for reminding their beloved for time to wake up. But how to stop the morning breeze blowing through Mandara Grove with singing birds and humming bees? Although dawn is a sacred hour, but day Rukmini never welcomed it. Going upset with her beautiful sleepy face, she would embrace her hubby up harder, not willing to turn away from his most ambrosial embrace. No matter what, but Sri Krishna does awake. He always wakes up, not at 8 a.m., but 2.5 hours before sunrise daily. Soon he frees himself from the snuggle of his beloved and washes his hands and feet, then rinses his mouth and sits on a separate seat, cross-legged, spineless, straight. With serene mind he meditates on his cosmic self, beyond the relative existence, the self, which is composed of a dazzle of pure consciousness, bliss and beauty. His Brahmic reality, which is deathless parts of power and superintelligence, emanating countless Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva every second. The same universal self, which flashes creation, evolution and destruction of all civilizations, cultures and religions. In the same sparkling, translucent, absolute truth of his own self, Sri Krishna stays absorbed for a while, my dear friends. And that's what you should also do. As soon as his meditation is done, his beloved Devi, who also had been jumped out of the bed, by now prepared for his royal bath, they plunge in pure water and swam in the swimming pool, then put on two clean pieces of silk dresses. Now Sri Krishna enters his special room and performs his morning ablution kasandhya vandanam and worship and yajna, a short fire yoga. Then he chants Gayatri mantram silently. He then stands before the rising sun and offers handful of waters to the sun god with mantras, and also to the celestial beings, and also to the rishis and to the pitris, and the starter and VIPs of his own ancestry, who are not out of his own self but his own race. Then he offers his respect to elders of his family. Then he offers ample donations to wise men. It is said, my dear friends, Alam Krebhyo Viprebhyo Badvam Badvam Dine Dine Dadauruk Vrabranam Shomalina Dilaisa. Sri Krishna offers daily 13,084 holy cows with cards, yielding abundant milk, gold-plated horns, and silver-plated hoops, and pearl necklaces, wearing pearl necklaces, digging their necks. He then salutes holy cows, wise men, wise ladies, and fulfills the desires of everyone dedicated to enlightenment. My dear friends, why he venerates holy cow? In order to see, in order to know, please read holy cow book released from ICC in Los Angeles. These daily donations were always accompanied with silk clothes, tons of sesame seeds, and sesame seed preparations, daily catechisms, and meditation seeds. He then dresses himself royally according to the need of handling the day's work. Vāso virbhūṇai sviyai divyāsta gajmule palai. Then he visits the temple. Then he comes out and delights everybody's heart by conferring most cherished boon to all classes of people whom he saw. Wise men were first to receive, then his friends and relatives, then ministers and counselors, and then his consorts. He honored them with sweets and garlands and perfumes. Then at last he accepts their gifts for himself. Right then appears his charioteer Dharuka with his most wonderful chariot drawn by four horses. Saluting the Lord Krishna, he stands there awaiting his command. Then holding his hand in his own, Sri Krishna mounts the chariot with Satyaki and Uddhavji. Then smiling at the bashful affectionate glances of the ladies, he then sallies forth to the council hall, my dear friends. Sudharmakhyam dhamam sarvair vrishnivi parivarita Pramishadhyan nivishtanam na santyanga chadurvaya. Sri Krishna enters the Sudharma council hall with his intimates. All stand up there and welcome the Lord. He sits on an exalted throne, illuminating with his own splendor. Around him sit the lords of Yadava dynasty. There they discuss the end result, problems of the state, problems of nations, problems of the whole world. They brainstorm what the house of master plan to eliminate the evils from the world. They gave warm reception to the rising monarchs and heroes and heroines. After the royal duties are over, jesters come, dancers come, magicians come and entertain the assembly, my dear friends. Mridanga vina mridanga vina mridanga Nanatur Gustushtushya Sudharmagadavandina. At times wise men came and gave these forces, and of course Sri Naraji would always around to serve the Lord in his own peculiar special ways. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.